Up until the Six-Day War, Israel occupied half of the holy city of Jerusalem. During the Six-Day War, it occupied all of the city and took over all the Muslim places of worship, particularly the El Aqsa Mosque. In 1980, Israel announced that it had widened the borders of Jerusalem and annexed what it referred to as United Jerusalem. Today, there are still more than 4 million Palestinians in various different countries. Around 1 million of these are eking out their lives in camps in neighboring countries, the West Bank and the Gaza Strip. The conditions in these camps are intolerable. Restricted living areas, a lack of infrastructure facilities, poverty levels as high as 98%, and unemployment levels as high as 60%. Furthermore, these poor areas have for decades been living under Israeli occupation and embargo. In order to occupy these two areas on a permanent basis, Israel established settlement areas. The Israeli army set up hundreds of checkpoints and barricades on the pretext of protecting the settlements. Palestinians going to work in the morning have to go through humiliating checks by Israeli soldiers. The illegal Jewish settlers on Palestinian lands are another element making life difficult for the Palestinians. Most of these settlers are armed and have carried out many attacks against Palestinians, killing defenseless people. They have stoned women, children, and the elderly, and burnt down mosques. Even the homes and cars of Muslims have been the targets of their blind violence. Far from preventing these radical settlers, Israeli soldiers have committed murders together with them. This graffiti is an expression of the hatred felt by Jewish settlers for the Arabs. By means of these settlements, Israel is sending the message that it does not intend to leave the areas left to the Palestinian Authority. Today, the West Bank and the Gaza Strip are still under Israeli occupation. Palestinian neighborhoods are surrounded by barbed wire and concrete walls, just like prisons. A Palestinian father bringing bread home can be mistreated before the eyes of his wife and children. He can be detained for no reason and subjected to inhuman torture. His home can be bombed, and what is worse, with his family still inside it. Palestinian woman can be killed by firing from a helicopter. She can be beaten while taking her children to school, or even shot. A Palestinian Muslim can find himself face to face with the guns of Israeli soldiers as he goes to the mosque. A Palestinian child can lose his life as a result of a bomb thrown into a school playground. All these things have actually happened, and Israeli troops are unable to provide any pretext for these killings. As the State of Israel uses its military might to oppress the Palestinian people on the one hand, it has impoverished them economically and taken away their means of survival on the other. All this pressure is part of a plan by radical Israeli politicians to eliminate the fact of Palestine. In the face of these facts, no person of conscience can remain insensible to the slaughter in Palestine. It is impossible to turn a blind eye to defenseless people being forced to suffer oppression, torture, and shooting by an army of occupation. All people of good conscience must be the voice of the Palestinians, and must defend their right to live in peace and security like any other nation. Killed and suffering innocent people are all warnings, constantly reminding us of this duty